How does Dr. Tai from the Medical Engineering Department of Caltech plans to change the world? How does he intend to accomplish changing the world? Now, medical engineering is very new in Caltech. In fact, MIT and Howard Hughes University is like about 50 years to 100 years ahead of them as far as medical engineering is concerned. So the interesting question that Dr. Tai have asked is that what do we do differently so that we can be ahead of the curve rather than be following Howard Hughes or MIT? He wants to be 100 years ahead of them rather than 100 years behind. The strength of Caltech is nanotechnology. So what they did was they applied nanotechnology in many of the medical solutions. So for example, when you have or when somebody has diabetes, no longer is it viable that you have an injection to prick and measure diabetes in your blood. You can actually have risk sensors that right then and there can tell you the level of your sugar in the blood, how consistent it is, without any intrusion at all by just your sweat glands. Another technology is in the area of our eyes need some constant oxygen behind the eyes. And as we grow older, that deteriorates. So his idea was, why don't you put a nano tube so that from your opening of the eye, you go back to the end of the eye so that there's an aeration, like an air conditioning system in the back of your eye. So they're using nanotechnology to be ahead of the curve, and they're succeeding very well. In the learning design world, I ask myself the question, what are we good at? And my conclusion is that we're good at content. We know content, we know how to write content, we know where to get content, we love content, and we profess content. However, how do we go work on content so that we move ourselves ahead 100 years rather than be using content as far as 100 years old? So what came to my mind was this potential ideas. Number one, do we know how content is today in relationship to the many tools and technologies? How does it behave? Number two, how does the worker, the learner, think of content? Do they memorize it? Do they talk about it? Do they dump it, or do they use it? And how is it that they can use it? Number three, what is the value of content to the culture of the organization? Number four, what is the packaging of the content? How do you package content? And number five, which is most important, is what becomes of content in a very high-speed, rapidly changing environment? We're still using our strength, which is content, understanding content, love of content, passion of content, knowing the sourcing and the writing of the content. But have we tested our idea of content and pull forward 100 years from now by asking those very challenging question? What do you think of content? How is it different today than the past few years that you've been developing them?